I was actually doing a radio interview when this news broke, so I didn't have any time to think of it either. And I was asked, breaking news, the justice has died. What's your take? First reaction is, we should pray for Justice Ginsburg's soul. We should pray that she gets to go see her old buddy Nino Scalia again. Don't forget, Antonin Scalia, who we all love, his best friend on the court was Ruth Ginsburg. And so we should pray for her because now she's gone and hopefully she gets to see her buddy again. I don't think we need to sugarcoat this. I've seen some conservatives come out and say, oh, wow, we all need to be like Ginsburg. She was notorious. She was so wonderful. She was so great. You don't need to say that. She stood for very bad things on the court, and we don't need to pretend that all of a sudden now we agree with those things. She certainly lasted a long time, and she certainly had some good opinions, and she had, as a matter of judicial opinions, mostly bad opinions. But you know, she's still a human being, and we should pray for her when she dies. Some people are saying this is a tragedy, that it's a tragedy that Ginsburg has died. It's not a tragedy when a woman dies at the age of 87, having accomplished everything in her life that she's wanted to accomplish. That's not a it's a tragedy when a little kid gets an illness and dies. It's not a tragedy when someone lives their natural life and has a life that they're happy about. Really, the only tragedy that Ruth Ginsburg endured is that the Democrats were so hell-bent on killing babies that they wouldn't let this poor woman retire. That's the tragedy. This woman didn't get 2 seconds of retirement because the Democrats were so intent on keeping one very bad court decision, Roe versus Wade, in play here. It shows you how weak that Roe v. Wade decision is, because that's what all of this is about. That's what the whole thing is about. Is Roe versus Wade, which in 1973 invented the fictional constitutional right to kill a baby in his mother's womb. And because there's obviously no constitutional basis for that right whatsoever, the courts have become hyper-politicized. This isn't about any other issues. Obamacare, redefining marriage, even really intense issues, no, those aren't threatened at all by these courts. It's just Roe versus Wade. When Democrats are threatening to burn down the country right now, Reza Aslan and Bo Willimon and all these people, they're threatening to burn it down if the right to kill a baby in his mother's womb is ever even remotely threatened. Consider, that's amazing. That's an amazing fact. That shows you that sometimes bad ideas drive people mad, or maybe spiritual things drive people mad, and it leads them to bad ideas. I hope you enjoyed that short segment from The Michael Knowles Show. Be sure to check out the full episode linked in the description, or download the podcast wherever you listen to podcasts.